Michael Faraday, September 22, 1791, August 25, 1867, British scientist who earned the nickname Father of Electricity, because thanks to electricity became a useful technology. He studied various fields of science, including electromagnetism and electrochemistry. He also invented the device that would later become the Bunsen burner, which is used in almost all science laboratories as a practical source of heat. The effects of magnetism led him to discover the ideas that form the basis of magnetic field theory. He gave many lectures to popularize science in the general public. His rational approach to developing theory and analyzing the results is astounding. Here are some of Michael Faraday's most popular quotes. There's nothing quite as frightening as someone who knows they are right. It is right that we should stand by and act on our principles, but not right to hold them in obstinate blindness, or retain them when proved to be erroneous. A man who is certain he is right is almost sure to be wrong. It is on record that when a young aspirant asked Faraday the secret of his success as a scientific investigator, he replied, "The secret is comprised in three words: work, finish, publish. I am busy just now again on electromagnetism and think I have got hold of a good thing but can't say. It may be a weed instead of a fish that after all my labor I may at last pull up. I happen to have discovered a direct relation between magnetism and light, also electricity and light, and the field it opens is so large and I think rich. I can at any moment convert my time into money, but I do not require more of the latter than is sufficient for necessary purposes. Shall we educate ourselves in what is known, and then casting away all we have acquired, turn to ignorance for aid to guide us among the unknown? Why will people go astray when they have this blessed book to guide them? No wonder that my remembrance fails me, for I shall complete my 70 years next Sunday, the 22, and during these 70 years I have had a happy life, which still remains happy because of hope and content. There is no more open door by which you can enter into the study of natural philosophy than by considering the physical phenomena of a candle. Who would not have been laughed at if he had said in 1800 that metals could be extracted from their ores by electricity or that portraits could be drawn by chemistry? Chemistry is necessarily an experimental science, its conclusions are drawn from data, and its principles supported by evidence from facts. A center of excellence is, by definition, a place where second-class people may perform first-class work. It is the great beauty of our science, chemistry, that advancement in it, whether in a degree great or small, instead of exhausting the subjects of research, opens the doors to further and more abundant knowledge, overflowing with beauty and utility.